gentlemen, WorldPool would like to welcome you to Fiddlesticks Billiard Cafe, located in the Football Hall of Fame city, Canton, Ohio.
Can you rip on Aaron while he's commenting?
We're there, welcome to host the king of the...
Look at the veins pop out of his neck. God, this... No.
Each player one match. The person that wins the most games will be deemed our king of the hill. Let's get started. First up, from Canton, Ohio, he is a U.S. Bar Box 8-Ball, 9-Ball champion. He is a 1999 Derby City Classic champion. Let's give a warm welcome for Troy Frank.
Yeah, Troy! Woo! Right.
His opponent, from West Jefferson, Ohio, he is the reigning All-Japan champion. He is the reigning ESPN Sun and Death 7-Ball champion. He is the reigning Sands Regency champion. He is the reigning BCA Open champion. He is the reigning US Open champion. The 2001 Player of the Year, currently ranked number one in the world. Give a warm welcome for Corey Deuel.
When you're bearing down on the leg, you think that was like a must do. Gotta get the leg and run a ton of racks on him.
Just trying not to scratch him.
The curling techniques there.
Yeah,
I like that.
You push the green towards
the ball, it won't roll as far.
It doesn't really work because it's clogged up.
Nice. Yeah, because it's Simonis.
Worth a try anyway.
Corey knows all the moves.
Troy wins the leg.
So, okay, now you're working on these breaks. Corner ball's going in a ton in this match. That was no exception. But did you guys find a particular spot that was working best for you? Or were you just feeling it out different places?
On side rails, especially.
Side rails.
Yeah, side rail with new cloth and starter tight rack. It's we can't hardly beat that. That's why, yeah, the leg was actually that important because of the circumstances.
Yeah, I've seen some touch breaks going on that Corey was trying and then crushing them, bouncing back and forth, but it looked like that ball was collapsing pretty good, especially in that break. Got wide open here.
Yeah, the tough was kind of getting on the twos a little bit touchy here. It's not dead easy.
Yeah. Are you going for side pocket here? Is that what's in your mind? Coming up
I think I'm just going to roll then and go corner pocket.
Yeah, there you go.
I hit it that way because the cloth is new and it actually slides, so the speed gets killed off the rail.
Yeah, most players would think fresh felt would just take off on you.
Yeah, it depends how you hit it, I guess.
A little butt a touch.
Well, is this 2-ball go past the 7?
Yeah.
It's pretty tight.
It's not tight from if you got to see the
you got like
dead on angle.
3/4 pocket.
Not if you're long straight shooter.
Yeah.
I don't have them young eyes anymore.
Gotta have those young eyes.
Yeah.
That's important. I gotta get that laser surgery.
I need a laser pool.
They got them, you know.
Well, with this 5-ball, what you got going here? Is this safety action?
Well,
you gonna try and squeeze in there?
I'm playing safe for the bank because I didn't like playing Corey safe. I don't like playing good players safe.
I was kind of pissed off about that.
Really? Well, maybe we should do it over.
I don't think that's an option.
Yeah, I like playing safe for the bank. In the spot, because I didn't think it was that tough.
You got to pump this in, don't you?
That was a nice shot.
Got shaped for a little pyramid action.
Yeah, now it looks like it's actually runnable. When I first started, it looked
like a project.
Good. Yeah, it looked tough, but now it's kind of easy.
Keep this pretty good here. Yeah, you're off to the races and.
Much about this one.
Keep world champion in the seat.
Little sarcasm in there. Like, yeah.
I like that.
on slow worn out putt, this would be a tough shot.
Yeah, especially on this equipment. This is a real tough table.
This draw stroke comes natural when the claw's fresh.
Yeah. Definitely makes it easier.
Yeah.
Got a little funny on that 9-ball.
I don't think you were even playing for that side, were you?
I was definitely playing for that side, and I knew I was going to come close to the 9, but I thought I could squeeze it out. Because when the ball's froze on the rail and you have angle and distance, it comes off the rail too easy to try to draw it straight there. That ball wants to jump off that rail, so I kind of played the jump.
Well, I got through that rack and kind of probably gave you a little tempo for the racks to come.
Yeah, you definitely got to start out the gate good in these matches. In any matches. So you don't want to be lagging behind and having this sweater.
See, I was a really concentrated. You just kind of checking out the
rat
girl.
And he's serious, folks. He was checking out the rat girl.
So far, I didn't have to really
worry about it. Yeah, so far, Corey's played perfect.
You think this will be something to come, these getting girls racking the balls for tournaments?
I think so.
Was it pretty good? It worked fine through this event?
Yeah.
It worked great. Yeah.
I think it's a great move, really, because it brings a little extra enjoyment into the sport.
Plus, it took Corey off his game a little bit, made him a little more vulnerable. I like it when you see little tiny weakness once in a while.
Right, once again, was that the corner ball that flopped in the pocket?
Yep. Corner ball in the hole.
See it.
A little spin shot here, and then I should be able to get on the 2 if I can kill my rock.
Yeah, really hit this soft.
In English.
Barely get that hole.
Where's the 2? Not that easy, but if I get on this next ball, it should be pretty easy.
You got a couple balls on the long rail there that's a problem.
Inside English. That's a tricky little shot sometimes. But new cloth, it's kind of easier to get it to take. You're more confident the ball's going to roll in, even if you miss hit it a slight touch.
Yeah. Even though there's some trouble balls on the rail, this is kind of out you guys really hope to get because it's mainly lagging the ball back and forth. Nothing.
Yeah.
No breakouts, No, nothing.
No
obstructions.
See, now on new cloth, it's even better. On old cloth, these outs are. You got to use a little more force, and these pockets are actually pretty tight on this table. With the old cloth, they're real tight. You got to be a little different position angles. Like here, you can kill the ball right here. The old cloth, it might be tougher to get that ball going up the rail.
Right.
For those of you that don't know, this is one of Troy's home town pool rooms, so he gets to play on this table a lot. So, home table advantage sometimes helps out. So, I'm not making any excuses or anything, but I have lost a first 2 games.
You gotta think of something.
Yeah. So I'm down 2-0. If you notice this. And also the crowd is kind of on Troy's side.
Yeah, that's always good. Crowd on your side is always good. You can always throw in a couple hecklers in there, tell your buddies that Corey's shooting in the middle of the stroke, just make all kinds of noise. And that's always key.
Only you know all those moves, Troy.
Like the pushing the cloth up on the leg?
Yeah.
Kind of like that. I think I learned a lot of those moves from Corey. I had to learn them somewhere. I didn't just make them up.
Now, you got that cue ball a little bit away from the rail. Now, what are you doing? What are you doing there? So you can use a closed bridge on the rail there?
Yeah.
Different side rail bridge.
Yeah, it's different than normal.
Is that the secret?
That's the secret.
Even the secret to this package. That's
yeah, it's definitely the secret to this package.
You notice that Troy used a closed bridge from the side rail. And he kind of had his pinky up on the rail. It's a comfortable place to put your hand.
It's easier to come. The angle of the cue stick is slightly different than if you bridge on the rail, and it's easy to get a center ball hit, kind of jumping the cue ball into it.
He's getting a little jump into the water, which might
Yeah, it's just easier to park your rock in the spot.
Yeah, your cue ball might jump back a little bit instead of coming straight back.
Yeah. I kind of learned that from Rudolph. Rudolph does that for you. That's where I actually learned
this three ball is a real tough shape shot. You gotta go sideways into between that 8 and 6, and anything shy, you're hooked. Anything
yeah.
long, you're screwed.
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure I left myself a cut.
This is a 3-thing cut.
Yeah, I just wanted to leave myself any cut at it. Because a new cloth, you can. It's still a little more forgiving.
Are you going to go underneath the 6 or above or try and spin out?
We'll see. I went into the 6. No. It got funny on the 6.
Yeah, it got real funny.
6 right on the rail. Huh?
You know, in my crystal ball, I see you getting out from here, but I'm not exactly sure how. You know, at this
at
point in the game, it looks awfully tough.
It's all good on the 5.
Well, you kind of.
Yeah, he's got that outside angle, but it's soft, so he can't really
you just
make his cue ball do
real
anything.
Soft, right? Leave it right there.
I think I roll down, play, and bank it in the side. I think that's a shot.
Maybe there's enough room off that corner pocket, or side pocket rather, where you can.
He's playing bank shape.
Because I didn't want to mess around with that point.
Right.
And then when, if you do make the ball, it's going to hit that point, and you're not sure where the cue ball is going if you don't scratch. So, and I was kind of, I made a bank the first rack. I felt pretty confident on that. It's in the same pocket too. So I figured.
Plus, he knows the table.
Yeah,
plus,
I know
the table.
He knows
yeah.
how the table's gonna bank.
Yeah.
You got a little straight on the 7. Do you just try and roll this in? Is that what?
I think I go to the rail and back out. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you got.
Yeah,
good,
I got good
angle.
That's almost perfect. A little bit shy from perfection. But I probably did that because I didn't want to go anywhere near that side pocket. And the cloth stuff, maybe the cue ball could get away from you if you get too careless. So right now I just feel like I'll just take the shot even if it's a little shy. This was still not no hard.
Televised event like this, it has to feel good.
Especially
to
your hometown.
Yeah, my hometown,
yeah.
Everyone,
all the fans are cheering.
Yeah.
So, you know, you probably had to keep yourself composed through the stress of this match.
It was hard not to do the tiger thing.
I guarantee you wasn't thinking about your run. I could care less.
Yeah, you probably
ran
out
of
my ball.
I wasn't watching any balls.
Looks like she racked you a little offset there. I think she's trying to put the gap down for Corey.
Yeah. Oh, Corey, give her a little wink.
Yeah, a little offset there.
No, that looks
point
great. That's great.
Right. Yep, there it is. Corner ball again.
Right.
Secret to success, running out.
Now, if I could just do that every single time for the rest of my life,
I think that'd be
real good.
You got a little length on the 2 ball, and then 3 goes by the 7.
All right, I'm getting a little bored of watching Troy shoot every ball. Will I ever get a shoot?
I hope not.
Just gonna pump this in, go to the long rail, back out.
Tough shot.
Yeah.
You trying to keep an angle?
It's a long shot.
Or are you just trying to? You go two and down. That's a nice shot, especially with the conditions of the cloth.
Yeah, you can slide it up the table.
More of a natural shot than having to try and pump it.
Yeah.
And then also, you know, if you try and pump it, the pockets will talk back occasionally.
Yeah, it could jaw up. If I roll it in like that, it's easy to control. So now it looks fairly basic again.
Are you going for side pocket here?
Once again,
I think so.
Once again, Troy gets a roadmap.
I don't generally play a side pocket shape because they can get funny angles easy.
Yeah.
But in this case, it's close enough to the side. Yeah. Even if I got a funny angle, I can get out of it.
Yeah, you got to kind of go two rails.
Then on the
inside English might.
On tighter tables, too, side pocket shape's good.
Yeah, you got the inside English working.
Loose tables, and you can hit the corner pockets, and it's actually a better shot than side.
Yeah.
Now, you gotta make sure you get a little angle on this 7.
Gotta go back and forth here, is that...
Yeah. Yeah, probably just go below the side and back out. Yeah, probably make sure I have a little angle. Come two rails for the 9. On this shot, you're better off hitting it short than too hard, because if you get
too hard,
close to that bottom rail, it becomes a real tough shot.
Yeah, you might have to settle for a bank or something.
Yeah, but if you stay high above the 9, you can always cut it in the corner. It's a lot easier.
That's easy to say if you really trust your shot-making ability.
Yeah.
You end up nutting it, so it didn't matter.
Perfect.
So is that number 3 or 4 you got there?
I think that's 4.
So you're 4 racks into just dominating. Now, do you have anything going through your mind? Anything that's... Are you just trying to keep yourself focused? Do you have things rushing through your head at this moment, or are you just staying with
When I'm playing good, I just stay focused with what I have to do. And here, I'm playing good. So,
you got no thought running through your mind right now.
So you're not
right
even
now.
Looking at the rat girl at all?
Probably not, no.
Yeah.
I'm not really even concerned one bit, just to make sure she racks the balls good. That's all I care.
See, that's the...
that's the difference between you and Broward. You can keep focusing. I don't check the things that long.
Yeah, so far, it's really screwed you up, Corey.
I know, see?
It's a nice little pop to the break and fire a couple balls in.
Yeah, but it looks like once I get on that 2, it looks like I got to get another good shot to get out here.
The reason I asked about that how you were going through your mind, I recently watched a movie that for the love of the game, baseball player, pitcher, and it'd be like a vacuum. That it just like everything would just disappear, all sound and everything.
Oh, yeah.
Do you feel like that's what you're going through right now? You got just nothing going through your mind. Just no, you can't hear anything. You can't see anybody moving.
Yeah, pretty
just
much.
Just you and your object.
Yeah, I don't really notice the crowd or anyone around me or whatever. The noises around me. Now, see, when you're playing bad, you notice
everything, and that's when
the crowd, the people,
when it's
the
easy
noises.
To get sharked. And
if a butterfly landed 50 feet away from you, you would miss a ball and say, "I can't believe that stupid thing did that right on my stroke."
See, that's the one thing most people don't understand. You know, it's like, you know, if you really got to do your best to try and keep from sharking people, but you know, if you're playing somebody that's running out, they honestly don't even notice you.
Yeah.
But the people that are jarred, you're going to hear it because they're going to miss and they're going to be pissed off.
Yep.
Like Corey right now.
See, I'm pretty pissed off. Well, maybe not.
You probably hear a lot of noise going on, a lot of motion going on in the room. You're probably soaking it all in.
I don't know. He hasn't
probably not very focused on anything. Maybe that rack girl a little bit, but
it's not like Corey's rattled. He hasn't even done anything.
Well,
so.
I mean, I might not even feel like getting out of the chair right now. I might say go ahead and run this out and just sit here.
I'll talk to you later. See, that's the kind of shot on new cloth you can hit on the old cloth, same equipment, will never go in. Yeah. So new cloth kind of makes the table play a lot easier. Right
now. New cloth, you want to play more towards the shoot the ball down the rail, you want to play more towards the rail side of the pocket.
Yeah, because it will go in for you.
Because even if you hit the rail going in, it's going to be okay. You don't want to miss the other one.
Once again, you got perfect speed of the table and look really calm, even though you're in the middle of a big package. You, like I've strung some racks, and usually I don't know what I'm doing when I'm in the middle of it. There's been a couple times I've noticed that I've ran like four racks, and I actually get excited over the thought that I'm like in the middle of this big run. Now, do you know if you had any of those, you know, sensations coming into your mind?
No, not right now.
You thinking about that right now?
Yeah, well,
that's got to be a thought.
It's a thought because that corner ball is like that. All I got to do is keep getting on the one ball. Good. So, yeah, that crosses my mind. Little things like that cross my mind, but overall. I've had that feeling like you said before, so I fight it off.
Yeah, that's
when I'm running a lot of racks, I just fight it off. I make sure I focus on what I have to do.
That's the key.
Yeah, it is tough. It's not easy.
That's a learning experience. I mean, like you got to keep on trying to figure those things out, trial and error. You know.
Yep. And the other thing, if I don't stay focused. And I make a mistake, Corey's liable to do the same to me in a heartbeat. So I know I can't even have, I don't have that leeway to even do that.
Okay, made a couple balls once again.
Now you got a 1-9er combo here. Or you can.
Little off angle.
Or you can cut the one in the other pocket and go through rails.
Yeah, it's a little off angle.
It's not that bad. I'm positive I play the combo, but. You know, I could play safe here, but under the circumstances, is maybe I feel like trying to run the set out on you.
Once again, it's almost salmon. It's almost up to the first diamond up on the long rail. So you got to back cut it.
Yeah, I got to back cut it. It's
not an easy shot, that's for sure.
But I feel like it'd be awesome on 9 on a great Corey Deuel. So I feel like I got to.
Now straight top gets you out of trouble, or you have to jack up and.
See, now if it was hill, I might not hit it like this. But because I'm up 5-0, I'm going to take a shot. Yeah,
swinging your shillelagh a little bit.
Yeah. You just barely missed it.
Yeah. No, I almost had a hook on the 5.
You could have played safe.
Everybody giving a round of applause because they realize how tough it is to just step up and run 5. Corey included there. Pretty gentlemanly thing to do, but
well, this is a tough shot.
Just out of five,
joints are a little squeaky, you know. Yeah. Got a little choo-choo action there, trying to loosen up.
Yeah,
you hit it perfect,
and
that's because
that's a sign of a champion sitting there soaking all that in. Yeah, gets up and pumps the ball in, but cue ball got away a little.
That's Corey's fundamentals. His fundamentals are so good that stuff he doesn't rattle easy.
So you coming with safety here, or?
No? So you know,
back cut in.
I was trying to bump the 3 up near the side pocket, but I went a little too far.
Yeah. Now you thinking carom perhaps, or?
He might be straight in.
Oh yeah.
Just shoot in the corner pocket.
I guess Jim Rempe has good fundamentals. Watch this guy.
Yeah.
The hell they all.
I honestly think there's some new guys out there nowadays that are. You got a whole new set of fundamentals that are far superior. Just like any sport, it keeps evolving. And people keep applying different fundamentals and improving.
And the other thing, you know, everybody is a little bit different. And Jimmy's fundamentals are real good for him. And everybody has different style and all that. So you, whatever works for you, I guess, is the best. But it doesn't hurt any to pick a one of the best players and emulate them by any means at all.
Yeah, I honestly believe that the sport's taken a little evolution, and watching McCourty's fundamentals is something that could definitely profit from.
All right,
there
I'm
he is.
It's like a mess. I'm surprised. At that barrage I took from
So we got 5-1 action here.
See, now I'm thinking.
Now neither one of us has really made any mistakes.
Yeah, zero mistakes, but the score would reflect.
Actually, you made one mistake.
Yeah.
You got me 5-1.
Yeah. You're 1,000.
I'm batting 1,000.
See, now I'm sweating Corey doing the same to me. How's he not going to make the corner ball and have a shot on the one? I feel like there's no way.
Well, you know, payoffs are always a good idea.
So I just hope you don't break off the rail like that.
A little pinky.
Yeah, a little pinky. Yeah.
Now, my break could be different from yours because I don't use that bridge on the rail like you do.
Yeah, that's why it could be different, but he's still got to make that corner ball. See if you can rip it.
A little longer swinging, but too. Not the pop.
Wow. See, and I didn't make a ball. Look at that.
See, Troy had a little pop action.
I hit him.
You hit him harder.
Yeah. I hit him harder. Maybe that's what happened.
I think that had a little something to do with it.
The balls just wanted to spin around. They didn't want to go anywhere. So Troy's back up to the table after taking a little bit of a.
Yeah, I just wanted to give you a little break. You know, you probably got tired of running out. You know?
I was getting tired.
So I'll let you go back to running out.
I might be in trouble here. I think I got straight in on this too.
Yeah, you're in trouble. You're up 5-1.
Well, I mean, not in trouble that way. This isn't that easy for us out.
No, it's only straight in.
Talk back a little bit.
See, I kind of knew I missed that.
Yeah.
So I had to, like, set the stage.
Yeah, you're trying to set it up for a tough shot. But
yeah,
it was
like,
dead straight
this
in.
Is tough. Oh, and meanwhile, I was dead straight in. I yanked it.
Yeah.
Nice stroke.
Well, I'm happy you gave me another chance, buddy. You're all right. I don't care what everybody said.
That's a touchy little shot.
Looking
right
out for you, Corey.
Another inch, it would have been no good.
Yeah, he stalled that real good. Keep that ball. Curious to see how much he was Corey uses every shot. High left, high, low right, low left, high right.
3 and out. Perfect angle into the 5 ball.
Good ball.
Troy and I were taught
now
by...
Now I'm full right on this 6. So
yeah, if you get funny on the 6, you can
get
straight.
I need to get kind of straight on the 6. Because if I get too much angle on the 6, then
you have to go
I have to be below it.
You got good, because you can draw it underneath the side.
Yeah, so
and then have to come out with an angle.
A little bit of angle here.
Using that outside angle to spin up table when it hits the rail. Spin away from the 7, so the angle's easier.
This floats nicely on by.
Yeah. Just make sure I can pass that 9.
Yeah, really have a good shot.
So we got a little 2-5 action, is that correct?
Yeah, it's now
that's manageable. You know, that's that 5 racks was huge, but 2-5 is like a race of 9. That's not.
It's not. Yeah, I got a chance. Nice. But I have to make balls on the break. I can't break the way I just
That last break of yours didn't really give you a whole lot of confidence.
No, I might have hit it too hard.
Thinking about possibly switching up. You know,
I guarantee I switch. I guarantee I switch. I usually switch if I don't do it.
Yeah.
I'll switch to something.
Like one try of no productivity, you go to a different option?
Usually. You'll see what I do. I
hope you wait
sure.
Until 2 or 3 tries here. Would be nice.
Yeah. If I stay, that's what I should do. I should try it like 5 times in a row.
Yeah, that
just
would
say,
be cool.
Damn, what's that? At this point in time, I haven't missed a ball for like 2 weeks. And You know, I was just...
It wasn't an option, right? Missing?
Yeah, he's just not used to it.
I don't miss balls anymore.
Okay. Center table break this time.
Oh, he's going center table.
Yep. Center table, that's like crush, stupid.
Hit
that's
28.
What mashes it. 28 miles an hour.
28
break.
Smash.
And zero balls.
Hey, you got zero action out of that.
Yeah, real good show,
so,
though.
28.0.
So, with Sardo Rack, that little pop action seems way stronger than the power.
I think it's the way he bridged the bridge on the rail like that.
Yeah.
What it was.
And you're not supposed to point that out.
Give away all your
shit. Yeah, I'm not going to have nothing
left. Little jumper here.
Yeah, okay. I think if I can hit it thin enough, I can get out for the two. And I hit it good.
Yeah, it hits real good. And that's
all right.
Didn't have much of a jump, but hitting it with that kind of control is pretty impressive.
Yeah, it worked out real nice. Now I should be open the book to run out here so I can get out ahead. Patterns.
Being dead straight here, you can keep a little angle to shoot the three ball railing out, and then four ball, and hopefully get straight on, which means shooting stuff.
Yeah, angles are the most important thing in nine ball. You can take an easy situation and make it impossible just by making a bad angle.
Yeah, now this is a situation where you're kind of shooting it, and natural speed puts you where you're not going to get angle on that five ball. So you might have to hit it hard and come out and back.
Yeah.
See, and
That way I come all the way off. That way I have another angle to get on the six.
Once again, being mindful of, he's shooting it twice as hard as he needs to just to get that angle.
Well, that shot, I thought you might have followed it two rails over to get straight in.
You might be right, but I'm thinking maybe with the cloth being new, it would slide off the second rail, would go wide toward the six, maybe. So I probably just forced it out, take the cut on the six. Because I still have a good angle to get on the seven from the six.
That's going
to
roll just shy of straight in.
I think that's good.
Yeah,
I think that's what I wanted. You're
probably going to shoot the eight, same pocket.
Yeah, just slide over from the eight.
Yep, and once again, good angle to where he can shoot this in and
can get back on
get
the
over
nine.
To the nine ball.
Low left, force it straight up. Now all I have to do is slide this into the rail, kind of rattle it in, and then watch Corey throw up. I don't know, maybe I can do that. Yep, slid right up on the rail.
That's what we're talking about. If you hit it right into the rail on new ball, it's probably going to
go. It's a good shot.
Just like on a bar table. If you're playing on a bar table, you want to play closer to the rail, right?
Yeah, you want to hit the wide side of the pocket.
You're gonna make some pocket there.
Took a little chance at that jump shot, but boy, it paid off big. Once again, with the emotion of the set being a little up, probably made you comfortable enough to get up there. But I think in that spot, maybe you had to do it no matter what, you know.
I think I did, just because you know, and when you play so many great players, you have to maintain on the aggressive side of pool. You can't always sit there and play safe and push and all that. I mean,
but those weren't options to you, though.
Not to me, because I feel like Corey, whatever I do, Corey, he's probably gonna do something exceptional with it. So.
Well, I mean, I'm kind of surprised you're really keeping your pull good, and you know, you haven't really felt too much pressure compared to, you're playing for some pretty big buildings. So, I mean, just the way you're keeping your pull is pretty strong.
Well, I just focused on beating Corey in this match, try to beat him.
Comes with a bank.
I got a good shot on the two. Now if I roll up on the four.
Was there a safety valve in that bank mindset, or were you just going straight through the
cajon? I definitely knew that I could get lucky and hook them because that five's there, and I believe the eight ball was down there.
Protection. Yeah.
I did have some protection with a chance to
hit a shot. So it was a good low percentage shot to shoot at.
Yeah. Yeah, at that point in time it was... Yeah, this isn't easy at all. And froze on the rail.
Yeah,
makes
froze
it
on the rail. Plus, it's like, it's a sellout if you miss it, because
yeah, it's a dead sellout if you miss.
You have no safety because you're straight in the hole.
And
the
even though this looks easy, it's really hard.
Yeah, the ball's frozen.
And if
the
you
rail.
Miss it, everybody thinks you missed an easy shot. I mean, I don't like shooting these just because they're just. I mean, they're.
I'd have to roll this. I'd have to roll this ball. I wouldn't shoot it hard.
Right. Yeah, roll definitely this. Roll.
More accuracy on the hit a ball easier than hit a ball hard. Yeah.
And if you get some, if you end up getting some inadvertent English.
Oh, dribble,
man! Now that really made me sick.
Sweet. That's what I was going for.
See, that
sick
roll,
factor.
That roll is what saved him there.
See, what we need in the camera is the sick factor meeting.
Yeah.
How sick your opponent
yeah,
is.
Yeah, I had a little puke meter on my shirt there. I didn't completely barf.
No, just a little bit. Thanks. See, I was going for the complete barf. The hand out barf bag shot.
Shot like that for the tournament. For like a $50,000 purse, that would be something to take somebody with a lot of ice running through their veins to come with.
Yeah, that's definitely.
But
I think you need a lot more luck.
Again, yeah, I definitely got a little lucky there. But again, there's the new cloth is the reason why I made it. Had it been the worn-in cloth a little bit, there's no chance it would have fallen. But I hit it that speed, like. Like Corey
you're
said,
curious with the side bridge game. Now. Watch.
He's got
elevated
little pop.
See how that ball jumped and stopped. That's why.
He's steady on this 19-point
average every time,
which is a solid, you know, like 7-8 mile an hour slower than Corey's, but it's paying off way more. And that's something for all the pool players out there. You know, you don't have to crunch the balls. So that was a. That's kind of a myth of yesteryear that if you didn't have a big break, you weren't going to go anywhere in this sport.
Yeah.
There's all sorts of different styles out there now. You know, people soft breaking, pop breaking, you know, all different speeds.
I was getting the shot on the one on that break, and there was no other break I could have used that would have been any better. When you find a break that works, it just makes no sense to mess around with anything else. That's why I'm kind of surprised Corey didn't do the same break. He knows the shot pretty good. And, usually he picks up on stuff like that really easy.
Dodge that 8-ball.
I think the only reason Corey didn't do it is because I was doing it. It was like a anti-Troy thing going on.
Yeah.
Like there's no way.
Never do the same thing.
Like the other day, Corey and I were at Subway. He says, what kind of sauce you think I ought to put on this? horseradish sauce or mustard, hot mustard?
Southwestern honey mustard. He says Southwest. I say, give me
the honey mustard.
Let me have a honey mustard sandwich.
So he went with the honey mustard. I should have tricked him and said the honey mustard just to see who would eat actually what I would have chose. That would have done my heart a lot of good.
Yeah, I think, was it pool we were talking about? Pretty much rudimentary, yeah. That's why these
Troy
guys are screwing around, because they got a little tap out there for the most part.
I broke perfect. All my angles were pretty simple. I didn't have to move the cue ball hardly at all.
Real funny, guys.
Look at him. He's enjoying it.
Look, see?
Yeah.
Look at that.
He looks like an otter.
He enjoys some quality play as much as the next guy.
Yeah, not against him, though.
All right. Okay, straighten one out, Troy.
Get it over with.
So I don't think that's going to happen.
So I still fear that Corey can put a big package on, be right in the set. I don't ever feel totally safe using an 8-2, but I still got to stay focused anyway.
Yeah.
Bear down real hard.
Yeah. What do they say? The last game are the two hardest games in the match or something?
Yeah. Seriously, that last game is tough. You know, I know when I'm playing a quality player,
yeah.
And I got him. few more shots, it's like that focus is just so important to hold.
Well, I mean, if you tie with another player in this format, it could come down to games to see if you really are king of the hill.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, this, so, yeah, this could be you, crucial every
right,
game.
Yeah, right now, you're needing to scramble.
Well, yeah, you want to win every game. Yeah. I mean, if you can beat me 8-2, and I'll send you a...
Yeah, give me a good start. Good head start. I'm hooked, and I kind of like kicking at this ball. Yeah, being aggressive again. I feel like I have a good chance to get lucky.
Bumping off the two and in.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, there's a couple chance. Opportunities there.
I need to really do something with this one.
Yeah. I could have rolled out there, but again, I don't know. There wasn't a specific excellent rollout that Corey couldn't figure something out with. So.
Just to dodge around these balls here. This isn't an easy out by any means. And you got these funny.
It is a tough out. Looks like the three is pretty tough to get out.
Probably a little tough
here. Go through
it. 1, 2, 3
Hit it good.
Yep. Actually hits it way better than you'd expect because he gets real close to it. Where the closer we get,
right into the rail and they go in every time.
Yeah. Weeble wobbles
that's
and they still fall
there.
Down.
That's a nice one.
Yeah.
Well, the speed's got a lot to do with it. Notice the speed through there for most of the
that's,
shots.
Yeah, that's what every
if
shot.
If you hit that same shot a little bit harder than I just hit it, it's not
going to talk back.
Yeah.
This one
come across with
that little dangerous.
I was running into the 8 there.
Oh, you were hoping to hit the top side of that 8 a little more.
I couldn't have killed it from where I was at. Notice I'm shooting fast. I'm kind of pissed off with that 8 too.
Yeah. And he figures what the heck.
He figures what the heck, whether you hit him back or not. You know.
True champion, you know.
Corey's like,
you know, really.
Corey's
showing the lion heart there, you know.
Yeah.
Either I get there or I don't, you know.
Eh, yeah, whatever.
Either win or I don't. But there's only one thing I can do.
He is right, though. He can either win or not win.
Yeah.
He's right about that. There's only two options here.
The only thing you can try and do is run out.
He can't tie.
You're not going to try and run out any different. 8-3, down 8-3 or...
Okay. That's right, man.
It's all...
Same thing.
Uphill from here.
You can't tie.
Okay.
Can't tie.
Which way am I going?
That's the
mystery. I went
I
left rail.
I say whichever way you get a better angle at her cleavage when she's around, it's probably what you're breaking.
Yeah. Look, I mean, is that all you want to talk about, Troy? I mean, we're not talking about drills here. We're trying to talk about pool.
Oh, listen to you. All right, Corey.
Keep seeing the success of Troy, and
oh, he hits it hard.
I just hit it 2 miles an hour.
8.2.
That might be a career low.
Crushed it.
Oh man, he made zero.
That might be
the
career low.
You made zero.
I made ball. You've seen some big time.
That's got
that was 20 mile an hour difference in.
Oh yeah.
In my brakes. The last two breaks.
What'd you do different?
Both ways, I didn't make balls.
That's got to be fatiguing because you're seeing Troy just make balls, and you've tried like 3 or 4 breaks and you haven't found anything worth a damn, really.
I think I missed this ball.
Well, if I was smart, I would just copy Troy. Oh, that was a tough shot there, Troy.
The cue ball was
the only thing scaring him. There.
I tried to cut it as much as I could to get the cue ball out from the two. Because if I hit it too full, cue ball wouldn't have gone nowhere. So instead, I need
see this. That vision right there was kind of what Corey was seeing. Nice blurry-eyed table view after getting stuck up.
Ooh, hook him!
Oh! I don't know about that one.
Good shot. Corey has a little horseshoe. Behind his ear or something. No, it wasn't really bad. bad shot. I'm sure he just hit center ball.
Okay, you draw up table and get out of this?
I think I'm going to draw
three rails.
Yeah.
That's
see, this is...
Yeah, just make sure that's, I get up.
Let's get you out in the open.
Out in the open. Get out of the
Yeah, out of the mess. Yeah. That's a good shot. It's pretty natural.
A little straight there.
I got
now.
Too straight, though.
So yeah, now with a little angle, you can get a warp for this six in the same
with
pocket,
warp
but now...
This is the warp draw shot. It's really super
uncork this one.
Yeah.
Oh, he's just kind of stroking.
That's the yo-yo shot.
A little snatch draw.
That is the yo-yo.
This right is where Corey tries to make me sick. See, Cody's trying to get even.
Trying to get even.
With that nine ball, I leave a water. And again, with the old cloth, there's
yeah,
no
I'm
chance.
Playing okay. I just,
getting beat on you.
I just can't get all the break.
I think you're just maybe a little outclassed here,
man. Scratch.
All right, nice well, clean approach into the shot.
No, he's kind of back in the set, 8-4.
Kind of back in the set. Still have yet to miss ball.
I think so.
I think it is true.
I think so.
Yet to miss a ball.
Yeah, you just, if you count not making a ball in the break.
Well, I missed three, yeah.
You missed about a good solid three there.
I missed three. Five. I think they should count not making a ball in the break if you miss.
Yeah, man. Especially really? As tough of a time as you have in there.
I think they should count it as missed because it is one of the biggest shots in the world. So.
Yeah. It is a pretty big shot, for sure.
Yeah. It's a feel kind of situation where, you know, each individual's got their, you know, different style of break, but if you're feeling it, you can make that corner ball go in, or if the one ball's the one that breaks loose for you, you can feel it. If you get in that little rhythm and you're focused,
feel it.
You can,
yeah. You can do that. You should be,
not every time, but yeah, you're not feeling it at the moment. That's for sure.
That's for sure. Here, I'm gonna crush him again.
Yeah, I see you uncorking here
just
because
pissed off because I can't make a ball. I want to hit it hard as I can.
Let's say like maybe a 32 mile an hour. Sends one out to the fans.
27 into the.
But he does make a ball finally, though. He does make a ball.
Yep.
And I did finally made a ball.
You know,
this is a good time to make one.
Balls are sitting funny too. What do I do here?
Right.
Check the balls are sitting tough. I just asked Corey, ball in hand? Just to rub it in when it scratched. I knew it
was ball. He knew it was ball in hand.
Ball in hand.
He said, hey,
ball in hand.
That's another
did you fly that one off the table?
What'd that one do?
I was busy watching the girls play with you.
I like picking on Thorin.
Yeah, right, a little straight in on this ball.
Yeah, I don't, straight in is not always good.
I mean, the three's over there by the right hand cushion down by
the four is in the funny spot.
Four is up top.
So you're going to end up being frozen on the rail on this shot. And the four side is a little down there. You're in a little bit of trouble.
Yeah, there's no angle to work with. So this out by most player standards is
okay,
almost
now
impossible.
You're frozen on the rail with the three. You're going to have to try and follow three rails to get down on the 4-7 combination.
Yeah, which is not an easy shot.
No, definitely not easy. Then I'm on the rail. So I put a little distance here so it flattens out the angle. If I didn't roll up, if I was around the side pocket, I wouldn't even have the three rail.
Now, one pocket player / nine ball player would maybe opt the bank here, cross bank the three,
I think,
and go up and down.
That's me,
that's,
yeah.
That's not a bad shot.
Yeah, that's me, one pocket player.
Yeah.
That's definitely me, because I did.
That
banked it right
see,
in the
hole. Yep, got that little one pocket stuff.
How does that
fall?
So what Chris is trying to say is I'm a one pocket.
Exactly.
Now that's where I really threw up all over myself.
But that's a great shot there, where if you cross the different styles of pool together, you're confident with that. Yeah. Not that Troy's a considers himself the high-end one-pocket player on the board, but he has played a lot of it, and that shot's probably something that he's got more confident at.
Yeah, had I
never played a game of one-pocket, you might actually fear that shot a little more. This one could have got a little more speed to it.
Yeah, I floated this bad here. But I could have, maybe I could have gone to the rail and slid down under the nine. Probably would have gave me a better angle rather than just floating straight down. But
you'd probably just kick it.
I think I just cut it in on that. But I have to spin. Yeah. I have to twist it.
See, now this particular shot here, I would try to keep this ball into the nine because you've got so many good things that can happen. Because if five can go off the nine on the side, the nine can go on the side or the corner.
Oh. I think I just twisted in.
Shot there. Yeah, he's got a little inside in. English showing there.
Oh, that really made me sick.
Yeah, he got away with it.
That's the perfect shot.
He got away with it.
It's just designed to make me puke.
Yeah, this whole set was designed. We had set it up, the crowd and everything. It was all a fake.
Sometimes it's
stage
like
crowd.
That, like, just everything's going to go wrong.
Yeah, sometimes it does. I don't understand what that is.
Got to jack up a little bit here.
Yeah, it's not that easy.
Yeah, this rail is making this 10 times harder.
Seems like I've been on the rail the whole set. What am I doing on the rail?
I think Corey had that feeling.
Well, he's behind the eight.
Alright.
Yeah, pretty good.
Well, yeah, see, that was, see that you were that trying to make me sick there. If you would have come closer to the side, then I would have been sick.
No, that was a good shot. I stood above the pocket and above the
nose. It would have been better if you would have titted it.
Yeah, that would have been great. Hit the point and then go toward the nine. Like
all right, just for all the cash. All
right, nice shoot, Michelle. You like
me
this
much. Right, Sneak is fearing a little chow.
He's trying to say that. All right.
So there it is.
Good shooting, Corey. Now it's been 2 weeks and 1 day we're fully done.
That's the whole difference between having your break working and not having your break working. Two good players, big outcome difference.
Whoever comes up on top probably
broke. Yeah, we both played good.